She just gets a little mad sometimes.
I won't do it, Mom. If you want it done, then you'll have to do it yourself.
Fine. I'll do it. Shut up, you whore!
mother? Mother? Is that you, Mother? Are you all right, Mother?
These years, and this guy was killing people in my town. I've been thinking, after all this is done, maybe it's time for me to retire. It's starting to be obvious that I'm not very good at what I do anymore. So we got the four horsemen now. What's next? Ah, yes. People with white robes having naked games. So here we go. When he had opened the fifth seal, I saw under the altar the souls of them that were slain for the word of God. And for the testimony which they held, they called out in a loud voice, "How long, Sovereign Lord, holy and true, until you judge the inhabitants of the earth and avenge our blood?"
You have a car, right?
Yeah, I have my truck. I'll gather everyone I can find and drive them to the church. That'll hold, right?
Yeah, that thing's been there for 100 years. Ain't no storm gonna pull it down tonight either.
This must be part of the sixth seal. Listen to this. I watched as the land broke the sixth seal, and there was a great earthquake. The sun became as dark as black cloth, and the moon became as red as blood. It's happening, isn't it? Yeah, it's definitely happening. So we need to do one more thing then. We need to spill a lot of blood. It says that the moon turns red with blood. That's where everyone will be in a storm like this. We better get there ourselves. The church is a perfect place for you to do this. You managed to turn this place into a sacrilegious mountain before. It should be no problem. Once you get in, I'll bar the door from the outside. That way no one will be able to get out. You can go crazy in there. Just paint the moon as red as you possibly can.
All this murder! Are you really sure this is what you want to do? I've told you before, it's not gonna bring your son back. What's going to happen here is, Lucifer is gonna come up and bring forth the rapture. Lucius is not your son, Jack. It's the devil's son. You're gonna be cast aside when he comes here. And you will have to spend eternity in purgatory while your son and wife stay up there in heaven. I know the boy kinda reminds you of your son. But the only way for you to spend time with your real son is to fight back against this madness. You haven't done anything that terrible yet. God will forgive your sins if you let him. You just have to accept Jesus Christ as your savior and prove that you are worthy. You're like a father to that kid. He will listen to you. The devil's side of him will not be able to resist the temptation. That's your key. Together you can take down the Prince of Darkness.
I think I'd let you kill everyone without fighting back. The boy here is no ordinary boy, ladies and gentlemen. The boy is the son of the devil. He may not look like much, but believe me, he is all evil. Together with Jack, they've been quietly killing people and performing some sort of ritual at their backyard. I saw it all. At least 7 bodies, all desecrated with evil markings made to look like the 4 horsemen and the martyrs of God. He killed his own family and everyone who worked for them. This boy is not human. He is a demon and must be killed. Die, you demon city! What the hell? What the hell? Get his soul. Let's grab him. What the hell?
The seal melted off, so I figured you were done here. Where is everyone? Something is definitely happening out there. I think the portal might be forming already. Do we really want your father to rule this place? Is that really what we're looking for? Making him do tests and killing his other children? I mean, what kind of a father is that? And what happens to me when he gets here, huh? I'm a sinner, and as far as I know, we both might end up as his prisoners. Don't you want to make your own rules? Don't you want to stop these tests and games and rule the place however you like? Maybe even want to have a kind heart somewhere. You've done everything he's asked, and you've got no rewards whatsoever. Without you, he wouldn't be able to do anything by himself. I say we go and find the dagger. Even if you feel like this is not what you want to do, it's still better to have the option to act in case something goes wrong.
I think we've had enough ideas from Mr. McGuffin here. Don't you agree, my boy? You know, it was me who got them to take that road that night. You didn't know there was a back door to my kingdom. True. We're now opening something that will allow my full dominion to ravage the earth. But in the meantime, my trusty old root still does the job quite well. Such a shame, really. You've done so well for so long. And just when I was about to take you with me to rule the whole place, I find you here, conniving against me with your friend the detective. You leave me no choice but to punish you. I'm grounding you for a week. And when that week is over, so shall be the rapture. Sadly, I don't know what will happen to you while the whole place burns down. Mortal souls of the sinners. And frankly, I'm so hurt that I might not even care.
You scared me!
Thank you. It's time to blow out the candles. Remember to make a wish, honey.
That's my happy birthday, son. Man, no.
Sorry about your friend, Mr. MacGuffin.
He had a nice soul. I liked him. Shame on Lucifer for doing this to you. Now he's out there and trying to fulfill the prophecy by himself. And you're here all alone with the rest of mankind. Left to die. Luckily, you can still change things around. Right down there. Just pick that up and stab Lucifer with it. Then you'll stay as the ruler, and you can do whatever you like. No more rules, no more quests. Like what Mr. MacGuffin said, you know that pet cemetery near your house? There's a mausoleum in the center of it. That's where the back door is. It's been said that only the wicked can use these back doors. And the blood inside your veins should hold the key. Do the right thing, Lucius. Don't let Lucifer get away with it.
What is this?
promising prospects. Eventually, they all turn on me. They all want the throne in the end. It all ends up the same. They end up destroyed when they raise their hand against me. And so shall end the story of Lucius II. What a waste. Goodbye, Lucius. It's been a pleasure knowing you. Gabriel! But how?
There we go. I followed you down just in case. And a good thing I did. The Prince of Darkness, bringer of all evil, King of Babylon, has perished. Let's go. Together we'll enter the pearly gates.
All the rising sun.